It's good too. Okay. Is it okay now? Tapakathamritam tapta jivanam kabibiriditam kalmasapaham shravanamangalam shri madatatam bhuvigrananti jivuridajanaha. The nectar of thy words is the life for those who are scorched by the world. The words which have been uttered by the knowers of truth, which wipe out sins, the very hearing of which is beneficial, which are beautiful, pleasing to the ears and pleasing to the hearts, which are inexhaustible. Those who recount them on the earth are the givers of plenty. Om, peace, 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 control. This evening we shall talk about stories of the Vedanta monks. The first part we finished here, the second part we started and we came up to 462 pages. These reminiscences was recorded by Shuklatmananda on Swami Sharadeshananda, a disciple of Holy Mother. Holy company is very important in spiritual life. You cannot buy in the market. Sri Ramakrishna asked, what is the way? He said, first, Sadhu Sangha, have the company of the holy. Second, Sadasad Vichar, learn how to discriminate what is real, what is unreal. Third, Ishwara Naam Gunagan, chant God's name, meditate on God. Fourth, Majhe Majhe Nirjan Vas, time to time go to solitude. Fifth, Bhakulata, yearning, longing, hunger for God. Chaitanya also said there are five ways you can get devotion. First, Sadhu Sangha, company of the holy. Second, Naam, chant God's name. Third, Bhagavad, read holy books, devotional scriptures. Fourth, Krishna Seva, worship the Lord. Fifth, Tirthavas, stay in a holy place. If you go to Vrindavan, Banaras, you can feel it, that whole city is vibrated with the spiritual atmosphere. Holy company is very, very important. There is a beautiful Indian folklore. A famous artist went to Krishna and said to him, Lord, I want to make a painting on you. I shall make a painting. Krishna was looking at him and says, my goodness, you want to make a painting? Yes. All right. So minutely observed his face, this and that. He was very famous. He used to make paintings for the king and the very famous people. So he says, please give me 1 week time, I shall bring the picture back. So he came after 1 week. He brought the picture. They find it does not carry, it does not go similar with Krishna. Krishna changed his form just to break his ego. Again he says, very disappointed, think of my coaches. I failed, I never failed. Then again he says, Lord, please give me another chance. This time also, you watched very minutely and made the picture. After 1 week, he came back. Again, Krishna changed his form. 3 times he failed. Then he was very disappointed. He went to a forest and found a holy man and told that I am very depressed. I never failed. I was trying to take a picture of the Lord, but I failed. Then the holy man said, you have made painting of the kings and the famous people, but you do not know how to make a painting of God. Krishna is God. I shall tell you how to make a painting of Krishna. So the holy man gave a beautiful mirror and covered it with a piece of cloth and says, take this one and tell Lord, now I made a painting of you. Just clean mirror. Just covered his cloth. Your painting is in this, under this cloth. You will see what you are. Then Krishna saw that this is true form. Then he said, now we can change any form you like, but this mirror will catch you. I did not make a painting of your face, but this mirror will tell you That's why how you look like. How to paint God in our heart? That is the question. You see, we meditate, we pray, we do all these things. We want to have a deep impression of the Lord in our heart. Why? Pandav Gita says, Nitto Utsava Bhavete Sham Nitto Sri Nitta Mangalam Yesham Ridhista Bhagavan Mangalayata Namhari. Nitto Utsava. Utsava means festivity. Nitta means all the time festivity is going on. Nitto Utsava Bhavete Sham Nitto Sri Nitta Mangalam. That person achieves a lot of prosperity. And all goodness comes to that person. Who? Yesham Ridhisto Mangalayatanam Hari. The person who carries God in his heart or her heart. That person all the time experiences festivity, joy, happiness. So for that reason, we need holy company. This Swami, which I am going to talk to you, I met him twice, in 1977 and 1986. I am foolish that I went to India in 1982, but I did not go to see him. He was living in Vrindavan. He served Holy Mother several years. At least 5-6 years in Janambachi. If you just see him, you can feel something. His action, his behavior, his talk, extremely learned, knows this. Anyhow, the greatness of a person, you can see through the little work, not in the public platform giving a lecture, oh, he's great. No, you must see that how he behaves with people. How he deals with people, his personal life. As Sri Ramakrishna says, watch a holy man at daytime and nighttime, then trust him. So he is a really, really illumined soul. Let me start. Triguna Sen was a education minister of the government of India. A very famous man. He was the mayor of Calcutta Corporation. And he used to correspond with the Swami. Sometimes he used to come to Vrindavan and stay with him. And he never sat in front of the Swami in a chair. Always with folded hands, standing or on the floor, sitting on the floor. Then he said that the present, he was a minister of the federal government, a big position. But if, I think then he's doing this term is over. Then he said, you know, my wife died, my daughters want me to stay with them, but I like to stay by myself. I don't want to be a burden to anybody. Then Swami said that you are now a quite elderly person, you should take help of yours. Daughters, they are eager to receive you. They will not be disturbed, you know. Please go and stay with your daughter. But I want to stay in a place where I can practice my sadhana, spiritual disciplines, and study scriptures. But when I am surrounded by too many people, they disturb my routine. Very sincere soul. Then Swami was telling, think of that, those people are sent by God to you. Mani, change your outlook. Sometimes I can, it's disgusting. Why are they coming and disturbing? But think, Lord Parashara sent that person to you. Change your outlook. You know, it's changing outlook is very, very important. How we can change our outlook. Then he says, serve them. Sometimes for the time being you may break your routine, but my suggestion is that it will not be all the year round or all the time. But in the winter time, Vrindavan is very hot and cold, extreme climate. It is better you go to and stay with your daughters. Bale ja Thakur Jochane ache Shiv Mandir ache Baba. Bale I go and stay near the Shiva temple and whatever prasad I get that I eat. Bale now go and take your mother's prasad instead of father's prasad. Your daughters want you. Lokabhav. According to time, according to place, according to situation, how you should adjust. The Swami is giving an advice to a very famous man. This is the way you can adjust. Then came a famous novelist, Gajendra Kumar Mitra. He used to correspond with Swami. And so Swami wrote a book, Chaitanya, on Sri Chaitanya. Very famous book. I remember it was in 1958 that book came out. And I think after that I was a reader. At night class I used to read. And all monks will sit there. The rule is the newcomer of the monastery will be the reader, night reader. And all senior monks will listen. So based on that book, he wrote a novel. Then came Swami Akunthanandaji. That Swami was a grandson of Balaram Bosu, who was a householder disciple of Sri Ramakrishna. I knew that Swami very well. Then this brahmachari, Swami's attendant, was asking Akunthananda, why do you have so much respect for the Swami? Then the Swami answered, I met many, many Swamis in my life. But this Swami is very special. I mean, I saw Brahmananda, I met many, many big Swami. But the first day I met him, from that day onward, I really, really very respectful to this person. Once we went for a relief in the southern part of Bengal, he did a lot of relief work. All of a sudden he said that, please, by boat. He said, I want to stay here. I want to go to the confluence where the Ganges met the Bay of Bengal. That area is jungle, some fear of tigers. It's a Sundarban area. Ami Sagar Dweepe jabo. So Swami Nirbhananda was the in charge. He said, I'm going to drop him. He put a little small bundle in his armpit. He just came down from the boat and just began to walk toward that confluence. But then nobody cautioned him and told anything about him. Then Swami Nirbhananda says, you do not know this monk. 100% dependence on God. Not 80-90%, 100%. Saranagati. One Swami Okunchananda and a few other Swamis came to Vrindavan. And Swami Okunchananda, he was a lawyer. He was talking, "Maharaj, from the very my birth, you know, I am watching Ramakrishna Mission. It is not Ramakrishna Mission, it is a Ramakrishna machine." "Ramakrishna machine." Maharaj was lying down. He was smiling and says, "Yes, I see the projection." "Seeing the projection, I can say that it is a real machine." "But seeing the projection, I can understand that it is a Ramakrishna machine." "Well, please come, come, Swami." You gave a nice answer. Swami Trivikramananda was the secretary of the Vrindavan Ashrama. Every day he used to come to Swami. "Swami, do you need anything?" And sometimes he used to come and give him a little massage to his feet and pull his finger. He repeated mantra so much, his finger became like this. So his attendants several times a day will pull the fingers. And he sat hours and hours and hours. So they will come and pull his leg to straighten out for blood circulation. I have seen by myself. He will go to the shrine, 3 hours seated there, meditating, repeating mantra, and he will go. I took some pictures. He will go in 1977. He will go with some books, and he has a prayer book. Prayer of Judaism, Christianity, Islam, Buddhism, Hinduism, all religions, prayers of all religions, he will read in front of Sri Ramakrishna. Amazing person. When Swami Trivikramananda would go to Delhi for collection, before going he will take his permission. After coming he will see him and inquire that, "Do you need anything from Delhi?" But if Swami needs something, his attendant may ask the Swami, "Will he bring this thing?" He will say, "No, don't bring anything, I have everything." Money. Santushto satatam yogi, Krishna says in Gita. A yogi has always full contentment. That is the sign of an illumined soul. Full contentment. No. Don't buy anything for me. He used to get so many gifts. I sent some money, I think, a couple of times. And he used to acknowledge. I have his letter. I used to send some money. Christmas time when devotees give some gifts, I used to give this money to the monks, those who are practicing austerity in the Himalayas, or some Sikh people, Sikh monks, I used to give money to them. So I sent money. No. But in his room there should not be any coin. Money will come, office. The Shavasram, the hospital, that it is a hospital ashram. All money will go to the Shavasram. Sadhu Seva. Spending only for the monks. Vrindavan, extreme climate, very hot. But he has a table fan in his room. I took a picture, his belongings. A wooden bed, wooden cot, a blanket, one pillow, some few books, and his shrine. Wooden slipper, and a bowl, where he used to put all food and you squeeze, no tooth. Only one tooth was left. One Swami offered, Swami, let me make denture. But then, no, no, no. No denture necessary. I make it mushy and eat it, that's all. I remember the day I arrived. Every night after supper, he will come in the class. All monks will come. Then some monk says, today Swami Chetananda has come. Will be there any class? Do you know what Swami says? He did not ask, will there be any supper tonight? And you were asking, will there be any class? Of course there will be class. I still remember. So the Swami says, Swami, shall I make a, get an air conditioner for your room, for the room? No. I don't need air conditioner. If sometimes late staging comes, we have a generator. Because in emergency department, hospital, quite often electricity fails. So we have diesel generator. Immediately the machine will be on. Same thing in Banaras and other places. We have generator. But please buy a good generator so that the hospital patients will not suffer. I don't need it. Some devotees gave some money. There is a big chandelier in the temple that the brahmachari was telling, and Swami was telling, Maharaj, very beautiful chandelier now in the temple. The Swami is cautioning that brahmachari, don't pay too much attention of the luxury, gorgeous, all these things. You know, ushajjo, wealth and all this show. But in the temple, it will be quite natural they bought all these things. But don't pay any attention of all these things. Nahi asmani tirthani nava deva mitshila mayaha. Te punanti urukalena darshana deva madhava. In the holy place, the earth of the holy place, the water of the holy place, the images of the holy place, if you practice worship and sadhana in those places, it will take a long time to be pure, to be holy. But if you see or serve a holy person, you will be pure instantly. It is from the Bhagavatam. Sadhu darshan, seeing a real holy man, you will be pure. Maharaj was very kind to all monks. Some once a monk left the order, but Maharaj was very fond of him. When he came to see him, Maharaj talked to him. I knew that monk. Then this brahmachari said, Maharaj, if you have so much personality, if you tell the general secretary of the Ramakrishna order, perhaps they will take him back. Swami says, if before leaving he would ask me, perhaps I would ask him, they will keep him in the order. But he did not consult with me. And already he left. What can I do? Sometimes friction, ideological conflict, ego, various kinds of things you know comes. Even to the monks. Maharaj was telling this brahmachari. Did you leave home for God realization, or you were a disturbing boy? Your parents threw you out so that you have come to the monastery. Swami used to, every morning, he used to take water through the nose and through the mouth. But it is called nashapan, drinking water through the nose and through the mouth. He says, if you do this, you will never get hijack. He was a very ancient school, you know, this is the way the yogis used to practice, so that you will not get any hijack. If you have hijack, you cannot meditate. Only I have never seen Swami has any hijack in his life. But time to time Swami was lying down, I used to read Holy Mother's book in the company of Holy Mother, Gospel of Holy Mother. But at that time I used to watch his eyes. He used to pitch like a child. He used to blink his eyes, and sometimes he used to smile, as if he is witnessing those scenes, as if he is present and seeing the mother. You know, we read with these things, but we do not have this kind of experience. But I was watching, the moment he is listening to Holy Mother's conversation, this and that, I saw his expression. Amazing. He would smile. But seeing him, I felt that his body is in Vrindavan, but his mind is in Jayarambati. One day I asked Maharaj, do you like to go to visit Jayarambati? If I had two wings buried right now, I would go to Jayarambati. But then shall I ask the secretary, Maharaj? Maharaj, I shall also visit Jayarambati with you. I have never seen that place. You are crazy. My body is so fragile, I cannot travel anymore. One day I was doing some room working in Mother's Master Swami's room. All of a sudden he called me. Hey! I had a vision. I saw some monks in Belur Mutt. Maharaj, are you dreaming? Maybe. Experience. Maharaj, do you have any relics of Holy Mother? Yes, I had. But I gave all those things to Belur Mutt. And when I was coming to this country once, Swami gave me some relics of Mother. Mother's hair and some other stuff. Do you know what? Mother gave me a rosary, but I lost it. When I was practicing austerity in Rishikesh, I went someplace and I put it there. Then I went back, but I could not get it. He used to practice Rishikesh, austerity in Rishikesh, the other side of the Ganges. They are called Shargashram. I visited that place, I remember, in 1959. So a young monk came to, he brought a suitcase, lot of books and clothes and this and that. He came to practice austerity. Maharaj told him, take few things with you, I am arranging a cottage for you. Only few things which is absolutely necessary, with that you go and stay there and leave the suitcase in my place. When you will return, at that time take your suitcase back. And he asked the chhatra, there is some inn. Monks can get food free. Some places once a day, some places twice a day. You will have to go in line. 11 o'clock, all monks will come. Some rich people maintain that free kitchen. So Swami arranged that this is a monk, he will get the food here. He says sometimes the monks push each other to get food quickly. You stay at the end. At last he will go and take food. He was very, those who want to practice sadhana, spiritual disciplines, he used to encourage them. Even though those things nowadays are disappearing, very few people will find, practice these kinds of austerities. His attendant told him, Maharaj, your chador, this is called chador, is torn. You need a chador. This devotee is offering and begging to give one to you. Why are you refusing? I told you many times, Swami said, never ask anything for me from the devotees. This is called aparigrahi, non-receiving gifts. Yoga Sutra bale aparigraha arthe janma kotha sambodhav. The person who established in that bhav, he knows about his previous life. Which is in Patanjali Yoga Sutra. No, don't ask anything for me. He is an amazing person. I shall not eat food without giving any service to the monastery. So sometimes he used to go to the garden and she used to remove the weeds from the flower plants, because this flower would be used for the worship of Sri Ramakrishna. So another Swami was teasing him and saying, Maharaj, what are you doing? But I am trying to get some medicine of a crazy person. He was making a joke. But on his desk, there was a picture of Sri Ramakrishna. Ma, Swamiji. And he used to put, there is something behind Sri Ramakrishna's picture, that whenever this brahmachari used to go, take the picture and take this thing out. So he used to move Sri Ramakrishna back and forth, quite often. He observed it. Look, young man, I see the presence of Sri Ramakrishna in this photograph. And that is where then I bow down. I sometimes, you see, you bend that photo, bend like this, Sri Ramakrishna, his neck bends, and you put things at his back. I do not like it. You see, we have the photograph, you know, just it's like, to him that photo is living. I see the living presence of Sri Ramakrishna in that photo. One day, this brahmachari was reading Swami Vivekananda's book, and Swami was calling him, but he thought that let me finish this chapter, then I shall go and see the Swami. Then Swami scolded him. Vain is your reading. I am suffering from pain, and I called you so many times, and you did not answer. You did not respond. Only reading will not help you. Who shall reading, or shall just to give advice to others? It happened to Swami Ramakrishnananda's life. He loved Sufi mystics. So he bought several volumes of Sufi mystics in Dakshineshwar and serving Sri Ramakrishna and reading in Sri Ramakrishna's room. Sri Ramakrishna called him a few times, but he did not respond. He was so absorbed in reading. Then Sri Ramakrishna said, "My boy, you have come to serve your guru. You will not get devotion reading those books." He threw away all books into the Ganges. In Vrindavan, during Sri Ramakrishna's birthday, in Vrindavan there are many monasteries are there. So all abbots and monks are invited for a feast. And the abbots, those who are heads of the monasteries, they say that you give dakshina very few, little dakshina. You must increase our dakshina. And some honorarium type of thing, you know. 1 rupee, 2 rupees, 5 rupees. But you must increase. Otherwise they will not come, you see. So Swami, this Secretary Swami came to Maharaj, "Maharaj, what shall I do?" Maharaj said, "You know, these abbots, they live in luxury. They get gifts from the devotees, a lot of money and this and that. But these ordinary monks and vairagis, nobody gives anything to them. So you better give more money to these poor monks. Those are ascetics." Then he says, "Maharaj, then these abbots will not come." So they have a compromise. They increase a little dakshina more. I was laughing. But the Kali Mandir, I am giving talk. What dakshina I get? Sometimes Usha brings a banana. Or some puff rice, or an avocado. But sometimes when she goes to the shopping, she asks, "Do you need anything?" A devotee from Singapore every year used to send various things to the Swami. Swami told him, "These are the things you send. I don't need them. And those who need it," he distributed everything. He used to know that. He did not inquire that, "Where are these things from?" I knew of Swami. Usha also, I met him. Swami Dhirashananda, you know, Konkol, Haridwar. In winter time, very cold. So I sent a nice jacket to that Swami, that cold weather, he can survive. So he, zipper, he will have to go from the bottom and then pull it. He could not handle it. He said, "Your jacket is good, but I do not know how to pull that zipper. I gave to the head Swami. He moves around, let him use it." He made a joke. "All the good things are not for me." He could not handle the zipper. "You will have to go at the bottom and hold it, you know, pull it." He gave up. Swami wrote a few books, Life of Chaitanya, in Sri Maya's Sritikotha, his reminiscences. But it is a great loss. Before he left for Tapasya, he wrote reminiscences elaborately and gave to his friend before leaving, please save it. Then when he came back, that friend said it's lost. Then he was really very sad. Then through meditation, again he started to rewrite. But he did some, but that original thing was gone. So precious, precious, precious. Then people thought that people misunderstand Muhammad. I shall write a biography of Muhammad. He reads Arabic. He knows Hindi, Arabic, English, Sanskrit, Bengali. He knew many languages, even Tamil. Wherever he went, he learned language. That language. So anyway, he wrote the Muhammad's biography. But everybody said this book will never be published. If it is published, there will be a riot. So, it will never be published. He translated Vivek Chudamani, but they are lost. He has a book on poem, Lost. He wrote the reminiscences of Turiyananda, Lost. Mahaprabhu Maharaj's reminiscences, that is printed. And Sharadananda's reminiscences, that was also printed. He's a beautiful writer. The Swami has a desire, you know, people go to Vrindavan, Parikrama, encircle the whole pilgrimage. People, pilgrims move around. So the Banaras Parikrama. So people should have Kamarpuku Jarambachi Parikrama. But do you know what? This time I finished one of my desires. I went to Kamarpuku last February. And then I decided I shall walk to Jayarambaji, 4 miles. Well, Mother, Thakur, they walked so many times, I shall be able to walk. So some devotees and some monks also walked with me. I really enjoyed my... And they made a video out of it. It is in YouTube. If person who was retired, Swami told him, I'm glad that you were retired. All these years you worked for your family, now you work for others. You work for Sri Ramakrishna's work. Give some voluntary service. That would be your austerity, tapasya. I see, all good and bad, all thoughts come, God is giving all thoughts. So, then what is our duty? He answered, look, how many people believe that everything is happening at the will of God? Nobody. God exists, how many people believe it? How many people think of it? To have this firm faith that God exists, people are practicing austerity. And that is called holy life, sadhu life. For that reason, one needs self-control. I was translating the third gospel of Sri Ramakrishna. This teaching is not in Bengali gospel or any other places. Ramdatta's first record of Sri Ramakrishna. He said, Karta chhara karma hai na. Karta means doer. Karma means action. No action is possible without a doer. Doer. I did it. I made this table. I did it. Doer. But if you have seen the beautiful image of God in a dense forest, you see the image. But the person who made it, he is not there. You see an image, at last, seeing that image, you come to this conclusion, there must be a person who created this image. There must be a creator of this image. Similarly, when you see this whole universe and all these beings, this is all created, whole creation. There must be a creator. If there is a creation, there must be a creator. So you do not see God, but God is there. As you do not see the maker of this image, but he is someone did it. Through logic, he was trying to prove that God exists. You do not see the stars at daytime. That doesn't mean the stars do not exist. You can see the stars at night time. A person asks some spiritual advice. He says two things are very important in human life. First, Bhagavad Bhajan, practice japa, meditation, spiritual discipline. Second, paropakar, help others, serve others. Upakar no, seva. It is not serving others, it is not doing good to others, it is serving God in human beings. Wherever you see Ramakrishna Mothan Mission, you will see these two things, the place of service and the place of worship. All devotees of Ramakrishna should cultivate this attitude, service and worship. Their home should be in the same way. Sri Ramakrishna came to teach these two things. A devotee came and said that I have a business. Day and night I am thinking about my business and business and business and money. I am busy all the time about my business and money. Where is the way? Then the Swami replied, it is good that you have a good business. While fighting in the battlefield, one can realize God. Why not doing business, one cannot realize God? He was talking about Arjuna. In the battlefield, he was fighting and listening to the Bhagavad Gita instruction, and he is thinking about God. Ma manushmara yuddhacha. Think of me and fight. Think of me and fight. That Krishna said. Think of me and fight. So what is wrong to do the business? You do your business and think of God. Beautiful answer, beautiful answer. Listen, he is telling this brahmachari. Before you go to bed, you must read a few pages of the Gospel of Ramakrishna. If not, at least one page. Take a vow that without reading Gospel of Ramakrishna, I shall not sleep. I remember in 1962, I went to Kamarpukur. I saw a brahmachari. Whole day worked in Calcutta, bought all goods for Kamarpukur, 60 miles by car, brought. And he gave his bed to me, the Vaidyanath room, and he slept on the floor. And under my bed, all vegetables, potatoes, pumpkins, all those things under the bed. Vaidyanath room just started. But I saw this brahmachari. No electricity, kerosene lantern, hurricane. He opened the Kathamrita and reading. I asked the brahmachari, it's called a Kantoda. And the Kantoda, you were reading. I took a vow that without reading Gospel of Ramakrishna, I should not go to bed. Habit. Habit forms character. Maharaj always asks people to read Gospel of Ramakrishna before you go to bed. Sardeshanandaji's brother is old and wrote a letter to his he did not write his brother, Swami Sardeshananda. He wrote a letter to Swami Trivikramananda, the head Swami of the center. But could you ask the Swami that we have an image in our home? I am too old, I cannot take care of the image, what shall I do? So the Swami came and asked Swami Sarvadeshananda. The day I left home, I cut off all connection from family. I cannot give my opinion to the family matters. I have no right to give any advice to them. But seeing, observing his renunciation, I was overwhelmed. I remember when I joined, one monk told me, don't keep any connection with your family, at least for 12 years. Otherwise, your two legs will be on two boats. One leg at home, one leg in the monastery. If father is not well, mother is not well, brother is not well, those things will come and shock your system. Your mind will remain with the family. You will never make any progress in your spiritual life. That Swami told me. Then the head Swami told the Swami Sarvadeshananda, Maharaj, you tell me what if I be in that condition, what I am supposed to do. As a householder, I cannot take care of the deity, what I am supposed to do. In that case, hand over that deity in a monastery or any temple. And for their regular worship, you must give some money so that it will not be a burden for the monastery or the temple. The deities, these images, they should give some money for the maintenance of the deity, for the worship. And if you see there is nobody wants this image, this and that, do one thing. worship on a very big scale of the deity. And beg forgiveness to the Lord. Lord, I'm sorry, I cannot serve you anymore. And take the image and drop into the Ganges. That is it. The deity should not be neglected. You know, these little things, so many things to learn from this Shraddha. So many things to learn. The Brahmacharya says, Maharaj, he never became the head of a center. I think he was some center, temporarily the major head. But most of the time you passed practicing austerities in the Himalayas, in the holy places. But what do you mean? Wherever I stayed, I worked with great steadiness. I never ate food of any ashrama without giving any service. A Vrindavan ashrama, I am here as long as I have my health permission. I worked, I gave some service. The old monks know. I did so many relief work in my life. I cholera patients, I took care of them, forgetting my fear of life. Yes, I practiced a lot of severe austerity, no doubt, but I did not move on like a pilgrim tourist and move around for fun. There is no hypocrisy inside me, Swami said. There is no hypocrisy inside me. I saw a Swami, I knew him very well. He became old, retired. But after breakfast, he will come in the kitchen. You see, in Belurma, there are 500-600 people will eat lunch, dinner. A lot of vegetables. He will have 1,000 servants and the monks and brahmacharis. They will have to come and chop vegetables and make the dishes ready for the cook. The Swami will come, a couple of hours he will come and cut vegetables. But I cannot eat food, Sri Ramakrishna's food, without giving any service. Amazing, these people. Up to this tonight. You know, I tell you frankly, these discussions, it is not a lecture, but you can understand what is called true spiritual life and the monk's life, how an ideal monk, how they lead their lives. Vasanta vallaka hitam charanta. As the spring brings flowers, bloom, so these holy people, wherever they go, they bring joy, peace in the minds of the people. Some people come from Brindeli, Lucknow, far, far away, just to see him. If you go and sit in front of him, you will see your mind is not functioning. It will still be calm, serene. All restlessness will go away. Just lying down, a little small cloth, bare body. I took a picture. I said, Maharaj, seeing your chest, it seems to me that you are 18 years old, young man. He smiled. And I took a picture. All right, after this tonight, it will be fun to know this person's personal life. Real, real, real holy person. Sthapakaya dharmaisya sarva dharma sarupine avatara varishthaya ramakrishnaya te namo jananeem saradam devim ramakrishnam jagadgurum padapadme tayushritva pranamami mohar mohar nama shri yati rajayo vivekananda surai sachit shukha sarupayo swamine tapharine Dokshina.